Welcome to the February the 6th, 1990 taping of It Happened in Grand Prairie. And this is our history tape number 113. 113 tapings of history. And we bring to you very special people that are involved in the history of Grand Prairie that have made history and are continuing to do so. And we are so honored today to have two very special, fairly long-time residents of Grand Prairie, Mr. and Mrs. Wendell Halsey. Dr. Halsey and Betty have lived here quite some time, and we're delighted to welcome you to the show, Wendell.
Thank you, Ruthie. We're glad to be here.
Thank you.
And Betty, I'm really thankful that you came when you said you just might not come with Wendell, because Wendell is so full of history and good things and happenings, and we're delighted to have you with us here today,
Thank you.
First of all, we'd like for you to establish your genealogy. And so let's start with Betty. Betty, would you like to look out into your camera and tell us a little bit about the real Betty Bell Halsey and name us your parents and give us some other statistics?
Well, my father's name is Odie Franklin Bell. My mother's maiden name was Jones. Her mother was half Cherokee, and they were from Alto, Texas. And then they came to live in what was called Hog Fork, Texas. I bet you don't know where that is.
Give us the county of Hog Fork.
Well, do you know where Cedar Creek Lake is?
Oh, yes.
Tool is there now, and It originally was Hog Fork. And they decided that they would change the name of that about 50 or 60 years ago. And my great-grandfather happened to be the oldest resident. And so it was named Tool after him. Not a very good reason for a town being named after you, but that was the reason.
That was excellent. And you did not give us your mother's full name.
Hazel Irene Jones Bell.
Okay, that is wonderful. All right, we're going to let you rest a minute, unless you can think of another wonderful story that's wonderful about your grandfather, The name of Tool being named for him. That is great.
Well, the next man was named Smith, so it was almost Smith, Texas.
That's excellent. All right, Dr. Halsey, would you do us the honor, too, and tell us about the Wendell Halsey?
I would be glad to. My father's name is Thad G. Halsey, and my mother's maiden name was Alpha Omega Bush, and they were married in Dallas and lived in Dallas all of their life, and that's where I was born and raised also.
All right. Now, and any brothers or sister, Dr. Halsey?
No, I'm the only child.
The only child. All right, tell us a little bit about your mother and father into Dallas. Did they come here? Was he born here? Where did they migrate from?
Well, my father was born here. As a matter of fact, he is a descendant of the first police officer ever killed in the line of duty in Dallas County. My father's mother's father is the one we're talking about. His name was Cassie O. Brewer, and each year when they honor the fallen police officers in Dallas, they'll always talk about C.O. Brewer, who was killed in 1892, and was the first police officer ever killed in Dallas, in the line of duty in Dallas County. And so there's a long string of Dallas County for my parents. My mother was actually born in Bogota, Texas, and her family had moved in various places throughout Texas, East Texas, Louisiana, Arkansas, and Mississippi. But she was born in Bogota and met my father in Dallas, and that's how they happened to get together.
All right, and did they ever catch the murderer of this Mr. Cassius O. Brewer?
Yes, as a matter of fact, he was captured that day, as a part of the circumstances. They were trying to serve a warrant on this fella, and his name was Henry Miller, and he was captured, he was tried, and they were trying him in the old courthouse. They were building the new courthouse, which we now know as the old Red Courthouse. That was being built at that very time, 1892. And there was such a large crowd, and it was so hot when they were having the trial, that they moved to the new courthouse, the old Red, because it didn't have any windows in it yet, and it was cooler and more, a little more room in there. So They held the trial there, and on July the 4th, 1892, he was found guilty. He appealed, and it was July the 28th when his appeal was turned down, and he was executed on July 28th of 1892.
Oh, that's a lot of history. Okay, Dr. Halsey, in the Dallas area, would you name some of your, like your elementary schools, your high school, and what happened to Wendell then?
I went to Asher Silverstein Elementary School in Dallas, and then Forest Avenue High School, which no longer exists in Dallas, and.
But they were they the Wolves?
No, that was the Tech.
That's Tech.
Prozier Tech Wolves.
Okay.
It was Forest Avenue Lions.
Okay, and, I'll go for that.
And we still have former students or ex-students association of the Forest Avenue High School. And so we get together on an annual basis.
Dr. Halsey, when you were going to Forest Avenue and establishing yourself as a student, what year did you graduate? How old were you?
I graduated from Forest in 1952. Mm-hmm. I was 15 at the time. Mm-hmm. And actually, I graduated at 16, and I think the 15 refers to when I first met my wife, to-be. Mm-hmm. And we met when I was 15 and a senior in high school. And she happened to be a few months older than I, 16, mm-hmm. and was a junior at Woodrow Wilson High School in Dallas.
Mm-hmm. Big WW.
And we met at a church picnic and weenie roast at Flagpole Hill out at White Rock Lake.
Mm-hmm.
So that was our first meeting. Her best friend was a member of my church Sunday school class, and so that's how we got together.
In your schooling, did you have a favorite teacher or a favorite person that maybe inspired you, that would make you make a decision if you wanted to go on to your education in a further line?
I had quite a few who were influential. And I guess my favorite was a lady by the name of Agnes Taylor. She was the toughest one of the whole bunch, but we respected her. She was an English teacher, and she mm-hmm. demanded excellence, and we always gave her excellence because that's how she demanded it. And she was probably most influential, and we loved her to death. She was tough, but we called her Aunt Agnes. And anyway, she was probably the one most influential.
What made you make a decision to go to Texas A&M, sir?
Two things. One was I thought I wanted to be an engineer, and the other was I thought I wanted to be in the military. And I might mention one of the other people who had an influence on me in high school was the commandant of the ROTC in high school. Mm-hmm. And so I thought I might want to go into the Army as a possible career. Mm-hmm. And the other was I wanted to be an engineer, and A&M was the best engineering school. So that's how I ended up at Texas A&M.
And spent how many years there?
I squeezed 4 years into 4.5. I mm-hmm. changed courses one time after having tried surveying, after having tried all of the basics of engineering, and before I even got into the surveying portion, I didn't know what engineers did, and I became disgruntled with the system, and so I thought, well, I'll just change to pre-law, which was mm-hmm. the other possibility of going to school. And after about 2 or 3 weeks in the pre-law course, I said, no, I think engineering is really best for me. So I had to finish that semester and then come back and finish up. Mm-hmm. So I graduated ultimately in January of 1957.
That's wonderful. We're going to leave you to rest a moment. We're going back to Betty Halsey. Betty Halsey, in meeting Wendell at Flagpole Hill at a church affair. Then did you all date for a while before you married?
We dated for a while. He's really my first beau and my last beau.
Mm-hmm.
And, he's a pretty special fella.
All right, and then you all married. And where did you live when you married?
We married in Winter Town at College Station
mm-hmm.
in a fantastic little two-room apartment
yes.
called Aggie Circle Apartments. Terrible.
Yes.
And our first daughter was born there.
Laurie is your first daughter. Okay. Mm-hmm. And as Laurie has come along, would you like to tell us a little bit about Laurie and her little family now?
Laurie also studied engineering at A&M and then mm-hmm. switched to recreation in parks, and that was her thing. Mm-hmm. And her husband, Ray, was from Fort Worth, Ray Pierce, and he was a drama and music major at Texas Wesleyan, and they met at Six Flags Over Texas, mm-hmm. both working there. They now live in Hollywood, California, and they have a daughter, three, Lauren Ray Pierce, mm-hmm. and they are all in show business.
I see, and that is your very special first granddaughter? Mm-hmm.
First granddaughter, not our first grandchild, but first granddaughter.
First granddaughter.
And in fact, Lauren travels with them as they do their shows. Ray has the Ray Pierce Production Company and the Ray Pierce Dancers that go into different clubs, mm-hmm. and they travel with him. And our younger daughter is Marcia, mm-hmm. and she is married to Ben Bryan, who is from Grand Prairie also. Okay. They met at our church.
Okay.
And they have a young son, Wendell Cole Bryan, who is 5 years old. And she teaches at Highland School in Cedar Hill, teaches second grade. And Ben is a fireman in Dallas, mm-hmm. and also teaches paramedic classes. And they
our
are expecting... They have the we have those two, and then we're expecting the third one. Marcia and her husband Ben are expecting one in 2 more months.
So this will be
number three.
Oh, that sounds like a great historical record all in its own, doesn't it? Okay, let's get back to Dr. Halsey. After you left Texas A&M, and you were just really lucky enough to have Betty with you, and where did you go then?
Well, after I graduated, and Betty and I married 1 year before I graduated, so mm-hmm. she basically helped put me through the remainder of my college. After I graduated, we went to Vicksburg, Mississippi, mm-hmm. and spent about 4 years there working for the Corps of Engineers, Waterways mm-hmm. Experiment Station, mm-hmm. And worked in some military time at the same time while I was there. After 4 years there, we came back to the Dallas area. Mm-hmm. We lived in Garland. I worked in a consulting engineering firm in Dallas. Mm-hmm. Did that for about another 4 years. And then in 1964, the position of city engineer for the city of Grand Prairie opened, and so I applied for it and was selected. So we moved to Grand Prairie in 1964. And so we've been here ever since.
Who was the city manager then, and maybe the mayor during in 64 when you came on board?
In 1964, the city manager was Clifford Johnson, and he is the man who hired me. And the mayor was Kurt Wagner, C.P. Mm-hmm. Wagner. Mm-hmm. And so I had the pleasure of working for Cliff Johnson for some 17 or 18 years. Excellent city manager, best in the state of Texas, maybe in the world.
All right, Betty, while you were coming to Grand Prairie, what did Betty do when you got to Grand Prairie, Texas?
Well, our older daughter was in the third grade.
All right.
And so I got active in PTA. Harry Eisenhower was the principal at Austin Elementary School.
All right.
And I think I went to one meeting, and the next thing I knew, I had an office of some doing something. And
yes.
So I served as president of Austin Elementary, of PTA, also at... Adams Junior High PTA. In fact, mm-hmm. I think I've held about every office that they have, and mm-hmm. was very, very active in that. And different clubs. I'm a charter member of the Grand Prairie Women's Club, okay. and a life member. And Wendell and I were both active in community concerts. I was secretary of that organization for quite mm-hmm. a while. And the New Horizons Study Club and the Grand Prairie Garden Club. And I was the sponsor of the Grand Prairie Junior Garden Club for several years, I think by virtue of having two daughters. I inherited that job.
Yes.
I can't think of any others offhand, but I know there were many. One of us or the other was involved in about every organization or fundraising in town.
And now that Dr. Halsey has reached the pinnacle and is our city manager here in Grand Prairie, what does Betty Halsey do with her time?
Well,
you work out of the home.
I consider this my public service job since he's in mm-hmm. public service, and I work for our state representative, Bill Arnold, mm-hmm. and I worked for the previous one, Carlisle Smith. Mm-hmm. So this is 5 years I've been doing that, and I just work 3 half-days a week. So that still leaves me time to shop and do other things.
Much to his chagrin, I'm sure. Okay, Dr. Halsey, when you came on board as the chief engineer of the city of Grand Prairie, who was your immediate boss?
My immediate boss was the director of public works, and that was Doug Driggers.
Mm-hmm.
And we worked under that circumstance for about the first year and a half. Public works was restructured, broken up into two different departments. And when it was broken up into two different departments, Doug took the community development department, and I became public works director. Mm-hmm. And so I served in that capacity for about 18 years.
About 18 years. And you also have had a tenure of 25 plus years, because not too long ago you were honored by everyone in this whole city for your 25 years of service with the city of Grand Prairie. I know that that has been a very special. Do you have any comments on that?
It was a great honor, and Betty and I were very, very honored by the turnout. There was a tremendous turnout of people, and you, of course, and you've known me almost that whole 25 years, because we started working together in the Civil Defense Commission and community concerts and all the various other things that we've worked in. And so I was very honored to have you and all of the other citizens to come out and take the opportunity to say something nice about Betty or about me.
And you had all your kids and grandkids and everything there?
It worked out so well that Laurie and Lauren were able to come in from California, mm-hmm. and they were able to be there along with Marcia and Ben and Cole, so it was very nice.
Dr. Halsey, after going through this chief engineer bit, did you go back to school to further your education? I heard about SMU in the background or something, and I need to know about all that good stuff on tape.
Yes, I went to law school at night over a period of about 5 years, mm-hmm. and ultimately received my Doctor of Jurisprudence degree from SMU Law School. And so while I don't tell many people that I'm also a lawyer, I am a lawyer in addition to being an engineer.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And did you use that profession any time that you've worked for the city of Grand Prairie?
Well, yes. At one time, when our city engineer left to take another job, the city manager asked me if I would like to be the city attorney for a few weeks, which turned out to be about 3 months, but I did serve for about 3 months, mm-hmm. before we hired our current city attorney.
I know that was an exciting experience, wasn't it?
It really was. It was very enjoyable, and it was different, and I appreciated the opportunity because it was broadening.
And since you did have the credentials to do either city attorney or the other, what provoked you to go back to the other and ultimately seek the city managership?
Well, I guess I felt most comfortable in public works because we had a staff that could do just about anything. Given a little bit of time and a little bit of money, they had the ingenuity to build, construct, develop, almost do anything in the world, and whether it was in engineering or streets or traffic control or water and sewer, all of those areas, they were really good, and I enjoyed working with them. When the opportunity came for the assistant city manager's job, I felt like that was an opportunity for advancement, and I felt like I should take that. And then when the city manager's position opened up, it looked like a need for the community, and it looked like something that maybe I could contribute to and I could help fill, so that's why I took that job.
Now, you are a very special young man in that you have all of these qualifications. Also, you've been hit with a very surprised thing physically, in that you've had a malignancy, as some of the rest of us on the dais have experienced. And yet you continue to work in your church and in clubs. Tell us a little bit about Wendell Halsey out of the city managership and into the community and like Rotary and good stuff like that.
Well, I have been, I've had the pleasure of being able to work in quite a few different organizations. And I mentioned, of course, the community concerts, earlier years, Civil Defense Commission I served on with you for many years. YMCA. I've worked in that area, and I've been in the Rotary Club, the Grand Prairie Rotary Club, served as president of that Rotary Club in 75 and 76. We are active in our church, which is First Presbyterian Church in Grand Prairie. We enjoy that. Both Betty and I have served as officers of the church. We just enjoy the people in Grand Prairie and in working with the community.
Betty, as a wife of a professional, and in the public eye considerably, and especially when he carts you off to Rotary and all of these other good things, do you have any special philosophy of life that you'd like to look out into your camera and tell all the young people that may be watching our show how exciting it is to be a helpmeet for someone that is that really aspires for these great things, and how important you are to him to see that that is successful?
Well, I keep telling him how important I am.
There you are. Go for it, Betty.
I have always enjoyed doing whatever makes him happy. That makes me happy also. And I've told him, when he told me, he came in one day and he said, I've applied for this job in Grand Prairie, Texas. I didn't even know where Grand Prairie, Texas was. But if that's what he wanted, that's where we were going. And I'll always be there to support him and whatever, and vice versa, I know, be the same way. But I think you just have to have the same goals and the same interests, and we both love this community and everything about it. And this has been like home for probably 25 years. We would not go back anyplace else. This is a fantastic place with tremendous people, a lot of potential, and we love it.
Wonderful. That's such a good testimonial. I ought to quit on that while I'm ahead.
I think you should. I think that's a good place to stop.
Well, we have just a little bit more time. Dr. Halsey, I'd like for you to look back to 1964 when you came here and compare the town and some of the few changes. What do you think have been some of the most important things, changes, since you've been on board, and forecast for us a little bit?
Well, it's difficult. We have so many changes that have occurred over this period of time. It's really difficult to try to pick one out. But I would say, of course, the growth, which we've tripled in our size since 1964. We have now this new lake, which I think will become the front door for our community and give us the opportunity to have better control over what our growth will be. And we've had good councils in the past to point that direction. So I think that just being able to control our growth, not letting it go completely wild, has been one of the most important factors. And I think that requires the city council to work on a day-by-day basis to keep that control.
Dr. Halsey, I'd like to know if there's anything in your upbringing that you remember that has really spurred you on, either that your mother or your father told you, some special goals that they had set for you. I'd like for you to tell us about that, and tell us a little bit about this historical research that's going on and how all of this came about.
I guess the primary thing that I remember from my upbringing is my father believed in justice, swift and sure, and he would mete out justice if it was necessary. So I had great respect for his word. Whenever he said something was law, it was law. Mm-hmm. Talking about the genealogy, my mother has been involved in the past several years, going back into some genealogy from both her side of the family and my father's side of the family. And they've been able to trace back into the 1600s on my father's side of the family. The Halsey name was really at one time, it's a Dutch name. I thought it was German all my life, but to find out it was more Dutch. And it was H-O-L-S-A-E-R-T, Holzart. Mm-hmm. And it varied into Hulls and Halsey. And she's also checked some on her side of the family, the Bush family, and goes all the way back to a Revolutionary War hero, an officer, and his name was Prescott Bush. And so there is some relationship. We're not sure if we want to claim it until after we determine how good George Bush does as president. But anyway, there's some relationship between my mother's family and George Bush's family.
Well, that is a pretty respectable tie, and I would say genealogically. And I know that it's an exciting thing. Do you plan, or some of your kids plan, to continue the research, Betty? Are you interested in it, or maybe your kids?
I think both our daughters are. In fact, I think we'll probably encourage the younger one, at least here, to go ahead and get involved in the DAR. And I think she might enjoy that. And then our grandson, Wendell Cole, through the Bryan family, is also related to Stephen F. Austin and a lot of the heroes from this era. So I think they might continue with this and really get a little more involved with it.
I believe y'all are about the most exciting couple that have all of these famous ancestors and kinfolks as I've had on the show. It's just really exciting. Dr. Hulsey, I think we have about a minute and a half or so left. I'd like for you, we have 2 minutes exactly left. I'd like for you to give a wonderful philosophy to maybe the young people that might be listening, that might really encourage them to keep on keeping on, going to school and doing all the good stuff.
Well, going to school, I think, is the key factor. I think it's more and more important every year that an education is going to be an important factor in anybody's life. I think it's critically important that the kids stay in school, and I think they also need to stay clear of the kind of influences, drugs and that sort of thing, that would have a negative influence on them. So that would be my encouragement to them.
What would you encourage them in the other minute that we have left on public service? Would you have a real good word for that, or do you think they ought to go into private enterprise?
I understand there was a former mayor of this city years ago who said that everybody ought to serve at least once, and I think that's exactly right. I would encourage anyone who might be interested in serving in public service, whether it be as an employee of a city or a county or a state or a federal government, or as an elected official, I would encourage all of these folks to take that into consideration, because if we don't do a good job, we, the public servants of this community and of this state and nation, then we hurt everyone.
In a half minute, I'd like for you to tell me the person in Grand Prairie, Texas, that probably has influenced your life more than any other. And I know that you have a lot to call upon, but if there's one special one, I'd like for you to name drop. And if you want to name drop three.
Well, if I needed to do it in the professional sense, the professional that had the most influence on me, I think, was Clifford Johnson. He was an excellent city manager, did a wonderful job for this community. In the personal side, I think the one who's had the most influence on me is Betty.
Betty. Thank you, Betty. Thank you, Wendell Hulsey, for being with us. And this is Ruthie Jackson, and this is History Is As We Live and Do.